So, Scott Disick embarrassed himself yet again, and Kylie is spoiling her daughter rotten that everyone is calling her a bad mom? And is Quavo begging to get Saweetie back after all that drama? Welcome back, baddies! Hope y'all are having a peachy day and got your cups ready because I got a whole lot of tea to spill. Shh. Okay, so y'all know about Scott Disick and Kourtney Kardashian's crazy relationship. Yeah, they broke up a long time ago, but that relationship has gotta be one of the craziest and most toxic relationships. And that's saying something because Kardashian girls are known for having crazy relationships. Anywho, since they broke up, they've both been dating other people. Scott especially been in the news a whole lot because it seems that he got a new taste for young girls who are barely out of high school. From Bella Thorne to Sofia Richie and more recently, Amelia Hamlin. And this is safe to say because the internet is filled with pictures of him and his booze. Not that they stay booze for long because he changes women more than some men change their underwear. But hey, whatever rocks his boat, I guess. So while Scott's been cuddling up to every young woman in Hollywood, Kourtney's relationships have been pretty low-key. She's only been linked to two men since her split with Scott, and they are Algerian model Eunice Benjamin and Travis Barker. While her relationship with Eunice ended a while ago, her relationship with Travis Barker is still going on as strong as ever, and girl, does their Instagram have some hot, steamy photos? And the relationship seems to be getting pretty solid. Well, as solid as a Hollywood relationship can get, but y'all know what I mean. And it seems like Scott is not a big fan of Court's new relationship because he got exposed for still not being over her. Rather than talk to Court about it, he decided to go the shady way and talk to Eunice about it. He slid into Eunice's DM on Instagram and sent him a picture of Court and Travis Barker in Italy. And he wrote, "Yo, is this chick okay? Bro, like, what is this? In the middle of Italy? Nah." Scott Disick trying to act like a dumb schoolboy, but then again, are we surprised? Yeah, I thought so too. Anyways, he obviously expected Eunice to trash talk Court, but Eunice wasn't interested in that, not even in the slightest. He replied, "Doesn't matter to me as long as she's happy. P.S. I ain't your bro." Shush! Someone get the fire department because that was a total burn. Like if that wasn't enough, Eunice decided to take things a step further by exposing Scott publicly. Talk about petty, man. But hey, I ain't complaining. I gotta stand someone who loves to spill tea as much as I do. Eunice took a screenshot of the convo and posted it to his Instagram stories, captioning it, "Keep that same energy you had about me publicly, privately. You go, King. I stand." He also called out Scott on his status again, writing, "Couldn't miss this one. He been playing around for too long. Tried to stay quiet and be the nice guy." Yeah, he's just really playing too much because all this is coming just a few weeks after the Keeping Up with the Kardashians reunion, where Scott said that he was in support of Kourtney's relationship with Travis. So somebody get Scotty on the phone. I got a few questions for him, like, why are you gonna lie straight to our faces? I mean, it's just super embarrassing for Scott. I almost feel sorry for him. Almost. Well, Travis Barker hasn't exactly said anything about the messy situation. He did like a post from an Instagram fan account calling Scott out. Then, a while later, he posted a laughing meme on his Instagram stories. Coincidence? Now you and I know better than that. While Kourtney hasn't exactly addressed it, she posted an article on her lifestyle website, Pooch, about getting over someone who treated you badly. And I kind of feel sorry for her. Not only did Scott treat her badly when they were together, he still ain't happy that she found love. But I think that Scott is a huge hypocrite. He's been flaunting his relationship all around the gram, and now he's mad that Court is doing the same? I hope he stays mad for a very long time. And since we're talking about Kardashians, let's talk about the baby of the family, Kylie Jenner. Specifically, let's talk about Kylie and her baby Stormy. Yes, Stormy is the cutest kid in all of Instagram, but we ain't talking about all that. We're talking about whether or not Kylie is a good mom to Stormy, because fans seem to have some opinions about it. The Kardashians love to talk about how Kylie is such a good mom to Stormy, and in a YouTube video filmed for Kylie Cosmetics, Kris talked about how Kylie would stop all that she's doing if Stormy said that she needed her. That's what every mom does. Like, that doesn't make Kylie a super mom. It just makes her a mom. Well, Kylie is known for spoiling Stormy, and I gotta admit that I'm more than a little bit jealous. I mean, she resumed preschool with a backpack that cost $12,000. Y'all, $12,000? But Stormy's latest gift has left the internet wondering if Kylie is that great of a mom. Taking to her Instagram on August 24th, she revealed that Stormy has always wanted to ride a school bus, so her daddy, Travis Scott, got her one. Imagine being so rich that your daddy buys you a bus. Can't relate. Anyways, Kylie got slammed after she made this post. Twitter users attacked her for not understanding that Stormy didn't want to own a huge bus and that all she wanted was experience of riding the bus with other kids. Rather than the fun experience she expected, Stormy was greeted by an empty bus and looked so confused. Kylie came under fire for not understanding what her kid wanted, but does this really make her a bad mom? Well, if you ask me, I'd say that the situation is kind of dicey. It would be super dangerous for Stormy to ride a bus to school like a normal kid. At the very least, I know that someone would try to yank off her $12,000 backpack, but while she can't ride the bus, Kylie should have at least tried to fill the bus with her cousins and friends so Stormy wouldn't be alone in the empty bus. The little thing looked so confused when she saw that bus was just empty. So yeah, Kylie loses major points for that. And I think it's kind of ironic that all Stormy wants is a normal childhood when normal kids would give anything to be in her shoes. Life's so weird. Speaking of weird, you wanna know what else is weird? Saweetie and Quavo's relationship, that's what. Rumor has it that 6 months after they broke up, they may be getting back together. And when I say broke up, that's me putting it mildly because that was one of the messiest breakups that my eyes have ever seen. And trust me, I've seen a lot in these streets, okay? Okay. So let me back up a little bit and give you a little recap. Quavo and Saweetie used to be everyone's favorite couple until they broke up. We didn't even know until Saweetie took to Twitter to announce the breakup. She dropped hints that Quavo had been with other women, writing, "Presents don't band-aid scars," and that love isn't real when the intimacy is given to other women. Quavo then replied to her on Twitter saying that he loved her and was disappointed that she decided to bring their personal business to Twitter, adding that she wasn't the woman he thought she was. Scoot, scoot! Yeah, Quavo, blah, 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 but were you unfaithful or not? You did a real good job of avoiding that. That part. Well, things got real messy real fast. Like, I'm talking poop hits the fan kind of messy. First, Quavo was petty enough to take back the Bentley that he bought her, which was super low of him. I mean, it was a gift, bro. Like, that wasn't enough. Elevator footage in Saweetie's North Hollywood apartment showed both of them getting into a physical altercation. It was a real fight, and it was super messy. It kind of reminds me of Solange and Jay-Z in an elevator, but we ain't talking about that today. Saweetie and Quavo both claimed that the video was more than a year old and that they had moved on from that incident. Yeah, that's cool and all, but that don't change the fact that they both got physical with one another. And if you ask me, I'ma tell you that once you get to the point where you gotta be physical with your partner, it's time to hit the pause on that relationship. Saweetie and Quavo have parted ways, and we thought we'd heard the last of it. But Hollywood relationships is gonna be Hollywood relationships, and rumor has it that Saweetie and Quavo may be getting back together after all. Yep, you heard that right. Speaking to Hollywood Life, a source said that Quavo misses Saweetie and he's been begging to see her. This ain't make no sense to me, because how do you go and mess around with other women while you're with her, then take back the Bentley that you gave her, and then expect her to still take you back? But it looks like she might. I swear, these Hollywood people be super weird. According to the source, Saweetie has been spending lots of time with Quavo in New York, and they may be getting back together again. Yikes. Saweetie denied the reports on Twitter, quoting the article and saying, "This is a Pinocchio ad article." So it seems like she ain't getting back with Quavo. Well, at least not yet. And girl, I really hope you don't, because you deserve so much better. And that's all the tea today, my daddies. Do you think Kylie is spoiling her daughter too much? And what are your thoughts and opinions on Scott embarrassing himself? Don't forget to subscribe and put your teacups in the comments. Check in next time, because you know I always got some tea that needs spilling.